Morning without Sissy, and I'll turn this way so you don't have to look at my dishes. So I have coffee, I have some cinnamon toast that I'm doing, which is where that spice blend came from. I haven't done cinnamon toast in forever, but it sounded really good. And we're having kind of special breakfast. Joshua loves to make toast, he loves to play with the toaster, so I let him do the toaster. So yeah, I'm gonna go eat my breakfast and finish editing the vlogmas from yesterday because I had an hour of footage and I'm not done yet. So it should be up really soon, guys. Can you show me your firefighter outfit? Show me. Got your helmet, your backpack, your hose. Where's your fire engine? You busy?
I'm busy if I put it out fire.
Oh, I see. You're pushing the water through the straw. Okay, so the boys are at the gym and I am supposed to be doing some cleaning. Or at least that was my idea, but I'm finding it really hard to get motivated. So I don't know how, if anyone else feels this as well, but there are days where I'm just like, I don't want to do anything. I just want to sit around and craft. I don't want to clean. That's not going to work. You guys want to sit in some coffee beans for a minute? You do? Okay. That's going to fall. It's still going to fall. Anyway, I'm totally feeling that way right now. I don't wanna
do it.
But I also don't wanna go sew. I don't know what's wrong with me. Why would I sit you there? I can't sit you there. I need to get my stuff. Anyway, I was about to sit you on top of my container with my Splenda, which I need to refill. I have no motivation right now. Anyway, I'm gonna microwave it. Busy schedule. I always get like, I just want to hibernate. I don't want to do that. I don't like having a busy schedule. I don't like having lots of stuff to do. I don't know how people do it. I don't know how you all do it. Doing all these kid activities and sports and all this other stuff that I hear about people doing. That sounds terrible. It doesn't sound fun at all. We just like to hang out at home. My kids are the same way. Joshua didn't even want to go to the gym. He was like, I stay home. I don't want to go gym. And he gets to go and play with other kids, but I think he was feeling the same way. He just wanted to hang out. He didn't want to have a schedule. So, yeah. I think we're starting to feel the hibernate coming on. Whenever I do too much, I just want to hibernate. So I think right now what I'm going to do is I'm going to straighten the area that I have all of my knitting stuff in that I showed to you guys in yesterday's podcast episode and try to get that, at least put all of the items in this box that need to go upstairs and get put away in my stash again. That'll make me feel a little bit better that my desk is organized and cleared off. So yeah, I feel like every day I'm putting up content of me cleaning. But that is really the reality of my life. I work and I clean and I play with my children and I knit. That's it. That's all I do. So anyway, enjoy. Put in a binder. I think what I'm going to do is make a binder of things I would like to knit in 2018. So that way I have them all together and I know I have the patterns printed out and I'll be ready to go for those. So I might do that later today or tomorrow. It depends on how things go. But sometimes Megan wants me to just hang out with her upstairs, but she's watching her tablet. So I'm probably going to save that activity for when she wants to do that. But, excuse me. Here's my box now. So I just have my markers that I have to hide from Joshua and my glitter pens in there. And then this bag has the rest of the yarn for Megwin's Christmas sweater, which I'm almost done with. I just need to do the seams. But it's blocking right now. Or it's actually soaking. I'm going to block it and then I'm going to seam the underarm. I want to see if I need to undo that neck band bind off or if it's going to relax a little bit with washing and blocking it. I suspect it will. And then this bag has my quill shawl in it. This bag has my Mabunden colorwork mittens in it, which I also would like to work on here pretty soon. And then just my Knitty Knotty for winding minis. This folder has my pattern for the quill shawl in it. And that's it. That's all that's in this basket. That's kind of how I want to keep it. Then I have this yarn still out on my desk because Megwin wants me to make socks for her out of this. She picked out this Baby Smiles yarn, and she asked me when I was knitting the Hermione socks when I was gonna do her rainbow socks. So I'm gonna do these next. She definitely needs more pairs. She's wearing the heck out of those Hermione socks basically every day, which is great. I love when the kids love the hand knits I make for them. But while I was doing that organizing, the mail came, yay! So my Cheers yarn came from Jinx Yarns. I'm so excited that I got this yarn, guys. Isn't that amazing? It's a self-striping, so there's three rows of red, three green, three chocolate, brown, white, red, three green, three orange, three green, three cream, and three green. So it's supposed to be all the different holiday drinks. So I'm thinking I might use this as my Christmas Eve cast on because they'll be great New Year's socks. But we'll see. I might decide that I want to cast on a sweater instead. But I definitely wanted to get this colorway, and I got it, and I got it on Sparkle. This is the box of all of the yarn left over for projects or from projects. Except for a few balls in there are things that I maybe started and decided I didn't want to do that. So this is my pink fluffy llama corn yarn. You can see I started a sock. And I decided I didn't want to do a sock out of it. I'm thinking I might use this as part of either my surprise party shawl by Helen Stewart or potentially the Sunset Highway Pullover. I might use this as one of the colors. I know I'm going to use the Dragonfly Inn as the main body color. That's not Lake Minnetonka by the Yarn at Home Mom, which is a very nice variegated purple. And what was the other one I was going to use? I don't remember. I think this one, though, pink fluffy llama corn. I need some speckly ones. I don't know what I'm going to do yet for that. It's not all fleshed out. I'm going to have to figure it out. But also, my Christmas gift from my boss came. So he sent me something from, what was it, Harry and David? They're the people that do, like, chocolate-covered fruits and stuff. So it's a little... I'm going to put this down. I haven't opened it yet, so I have no idea what's in it. Let's move my apple. It's a little house. Got snow on the top, but it's fleece. So the kids will probably have fun with this box. I'll definitely save the box to reuse later. It might be good for storing ornaments in because it's nice and tall. Yeah. Oh, there's all kinds of goodies in here. There's some lemon shortbread cookies. I'm not going to be able to let Joshua see this because he'll go freaking nuts. The cookie bean, some little mint chocolate candies, some yogurt covered pretzels, milk chocolate truffles, and Moose Munch milk chocolate popcorn. So I'll eat that soon because popcorn's probably going to be the least preservative of all of those items. Those and the cookies. So actually, yeah. Put the cookies on top. I'll keep this ribbon because the kids will have fun with that. I'm thinking maybe I'll leave it on my desk as like a little Christmas decoration. That's nice. So yeah, there we go. Feeling pretty good. I feel like I really made a lot of progress. I'm much happier with how my desk looks. It's very open. I don't feel like things are crashing in on me, which I definitely was feeling like before. So yeah, and then I haven't shared my minis with you for a few days that I've been getting from Anna. So this is the one from today. And very few of them are labeled. So this one's not labeled. I don't know what it is. And then there was this one from, I think, yesterday. Again, not labeled, but I really like it. It's autumnal colors. And then today I also got a little Ritter Sport, which it looks like it's a milk chocolate crisp, similar to Crackle, for those of you in the United States. Goodness. Just checked mail, and there's already more mail coming. So I'm going to move this yarn box. Take a ride in the yarn box, guys. I'm just going to move it over to the side here for right now, because I'm not going to go upstairs. Because I don't want to. This is probably our normal mail. The other was packages. For whatever reason, they do them separately. I don't know why. It wasn't even worth opening the door for. It's just an ad. Oh my goodness. Okay. So, I'm going to have a little bit of something to eat and work just a tiny bit on my socks. The boys will probably be home pretty soon, and then the gingerbread house building is at 12:30. So we will probably be getting ready to go. We'll probably leave at noon, so not too long before we'll be getting ready to go. Looking good, Megs. Oh, I like your rainbow candy cane over there. That's nice.
I'm making lights.
Oh, yeah, we got some lights, too. Oh, I like that you're doing, like, a little string on the end. What is it, bub? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, he's trying to show you his house.
You want to try?
Oh, that's good. I like that.
You want me to turn it, buddy?
Candy cane, the more you're going to knock it down. Yeah, maybe I'll overcome it. Oh, yeah, it's kind of neat now.
Is it delicious? Oh, I like that, Megs. Getting some lights on it. Sweet.
I'm unfortunately not secure. I should have set that in the very beginning so it could dry the whole time.
Yeah.
Using interior materials. I tried to rush the concrete.
Would you guys like some hot chocolate?
You guys ready?
Here comes Buddy.
I'm wishing for you.
Hey guys, I've stolen the children's fox hood. I don't know where my hats are. So this works, right? Ha! It's hilarious. This is so ridiculous. Uh-oh. I'll have to tell my husband that. He should come out and turn off that thing. The lights on in the other car. Anyway. So Penguin had a bit of a cough yesterday. Turn this on for you. And it got a lot worse while she was at Emma's. Like to the point where she's just constantly coughing. So I'm going to get medicine. Not really medicine, but Vicks. So for those of you who are familiar, Vicks has like a cough suppressant camphor that you put into a vaporizer, and then they're breathing in the steam overnight in a hot vaporizer. So they're breathing in the steam overnight, and it really helps them not cough, which then they get better rest. And I find it really helps me when I have a bad cough. So we're planning on setting her up with that tonight. I also think that she stayed up way too late last night with Emma, which I expected because it's a slumber party and that's what you do at slumber parties. But I know, like I said in my Vlogmas for last night, that they at least were up until 10:30. Maybe I said that in the Vlogmas this morning. I'm losing track. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. Regardless, they were up way too late. So she's tired. She hasn't had good rest. Right now she's taking a shower, like a hot shower. So hopefully that'll help loosen everything up. We'll give her some more cough syrup. And then I just want her to take it easy. I really, really hope that she starts getting better. If she's not better by Monday, I'm definitely going to get her into the doctor, because my mom is on some medication that is immune suppressing. So if the kids are sick, we won't be able to go over there for Christmas. And I don't want to do that to them again, because last year Joshua was puking. So we didn't get to spend Christmas Eve with them. We did go over Christmas Day, but it was pretty subdued. So hopefully we can get this thing knocked out and she'll be better. But off I go to the drugstore. Hey guys. So we are winding down here. Megwin's cough got way, way worse this evening. So she is upstairs with the steam machine. I went to go get steam at the drugstore and it was crazy. So I got a $10 coupon, a gift card basically for last time I was at the drugstore. I bought something and it had a $10 gift card thing that it came with. So I didn't know how to use it, and the cashier clearly didn't either. She ended up charging me $10, so it was a whole thing, and then like there was no manager to void it. Anyway, it took forever, but I bought three of the Vicks VapoSteam things, so we should be good for a while. I also got more cough medicine for her. So we're settling in, and like I said, if she's not better by Monday, I'll go ahead and get her into the doctor and hopefully get her on antibiotics. So we're just taking it easy. I am knitting on my second peppermint mocha sock. I'm almost done with the leg of the second one. These have to be a little bit short on the legs because of how tight the pattern is. So where that little teacup is, the peppermint mocha, is where the heel starts. So you can see I'm actually about halfway down that leg, but it is going fast. So I want to get to the heel tonight and then maybe complete the foot tomorrow. I was super unmotivated to do anything today. But like I said, I got my desk done, and the 10-stitch blanket is making a reappearance. I'm just snuggled under it right now. I don't have my second needle, so I couldn't knit on it, but that's okay. I'm just enjoying snuggling it, and it's just the right temperature for it. It was kind of warm today. It got up to 48 degrees, so I had on my really warm jacket, and it was actually too warm. I ended up taking it off in the car. Megwyn left her bag at her friend's house, so we had to drive all the way over to get it. She lives on the other side of town, so it was an extra hour of driving to go get it, and then we had to go to the store. It's been a really stressful day. I'm tired. I'm ready to just chill for a little while, knit a little bit, and then go to bed. So I'm going to leave it here, and I will see you guys tomorrow. Okay.